Alright guys, we're back in my garage for another video, and today we're going to be talking about the B58 again. I wanted to make this video because I've seen a lot of conversations from people that are trying to understand the different versions of the B58 and what vehicle has which version, and especially with some of my latest videos covering the new Gen 3 TU2 engine, a lot of people are trying to understand when is that going to get to their platform or if they're ever going to see it. So in this video, I'll try to cover all the details that I have to help you understand what version is in your car, how you can look at a B58 engine and tell what B58 version it is, as well as what kind of model years and generations of BMWs have various versions of the B58. So hopefully this will help you out if you're just curious, or maybe you're looking at buying a new car and you want to make sure you target a specific version. This should help break all of that down for you. Now, as always, for everybody that's new to the channel, I create videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in videos like that, be sure to subscribe because there will be a lot more coming out in the future. So yeah, we're going to break down the B58 versions, and I know a lot of people kind of get mixed up by this, but especially for those of us that have been in the B58 community for a while, we know when it was introduced, BMW definitely struck gold. And I'm coming from the Volkswagen platform before I got into BMW, and they had a similar situation. They introduced the 2-liter TSI back in 2008, and they realized that they had really nailed it with that one because it was so much more reliable and efficient compared to their older engines. So after that, they basically just kept revising it for new models, and they've been making it for, you know, going on 15 years now. B58 is the same way, you know, so the Gen 1 version came out a long time ago, but BMW has continued to do technical updates to it to revise it and make it more efficient and make more power, but that also can cause a little bit of confusion. So we're going to go ahead and start at the very beginning, and we can go all the way back to 2015 when the Gen 1 B58 was introduced. Now, the nomenclature for this, from technically speaking, is B58 B30 M0. And this version of the B58 was extremely simple. There was no 2-port and 6-port version or any sort of complexity like that. BMW just put different tunes on the B58 depending on the platform it was going in. So it ranged anywhere from 320 horsepower in cars like mine, if you had a 340 or 440i, and it went all the way up to 355 horsepower. So they offered factory calibration upgrade tunes that I could buy and basically put an M performance tune on my car to bump it up and give it an extra 35 horsepower. So it was a really cool option to have and gave people a lot of flexibility in how, you know, they wanted to basically put their money in their car. If you just wanted a stock car, then you could drive it with 320 horsepower. If you wanted a slightly better performing version, you could get like an M240 or something like that with the mid, like 330 to 340 horsepower, or some cars came with that MPPSK tune that bumped it all the way up to the full 355. Now, after that, in 2019, BMW introduced the B58 TU, and this is where things got a little more complicated. So there were two different versions of the B58 TU. There was the 2-port version, that was the lower output model. The technical designation for this was B58 B30 M0, or it was also called B58C. This came with 335 horsepower, and like I said, it had the 2-port cylinder head. So it's really obvious if you look at it in the turbo, there are just two runners going to the turbo instead of the typical six for a 6-cylinder engine. They also had the high output version. So this is also known as the 6-port TU engine. The technical designation was B58B3001, or it was also known as B58D. So this came out with over 380 horsepower, and this was typically the more desirable one because it had so much more power, but there were kind of pros and cons for it, and so BMW had to make both. Now, after that, they most recently came out with the B58 TU2. This is still kind of rolling out, so right now we only have one version available. It is a 2-port cylinder head, and the technical designation is B58 B30 M2, or it's also known as B58N. They just started putting this in vehicles for the 2023 model year, so we'll see in the future what other vehicles it comes into, but it's really fresh and new to us right now, so there's not as much information available. But the good news is that it is a 2-port, quote-unquote, low-output version, and it now makes 370 horsepower, so almost as much as the previous high-output version. And that makes us hopeful that a new 6-port engine will come out in the future that'll make closer to 400, if not more, and that'll just be a real force to be reckoned with. So now let's talk about the actual differences and what you can look at in the engine bay to tell what version of the B58 you're looking at. Now, one of the main things people recommend looking at is the high pressure fuel pump. On the Gen 1 B58, it has this big dip in it, whereas on the TU engines, it has a round dome. So if you're looking at one with a dip, then you definitely know that it's a Gen 1. Another difference is that the connector points to the front on the Gen 1, whereas on the TU engines, it points towards the back and basically points towards the cabin. So if you have the connector pointing towards the front of the car, that's also a good indication that you have a Gen 1 B58. Now, the TU pump is typically retrofitted to Gen 1 B58s in an attempt to support more power since it flows more fuel. So just because it has a TU high pressure fuel pump on the car, it doesn't necessarily mean it's a TU engine. In most cases, it probably is, especially if it's a stock car, but there's not really a guarantee, especially if you're buying it from an enthusiast. Now, something that enthusiasts don't typically modify is the valve cover, and this is very different between a Gen 1 and a TU engine. On the Gen 1, if you look at the PCV port towards the front of the engine, you can see that it actually points towards the intake. So if you want to remove that connector, you have to squeeze the sides and pull towards the front of the car in order to disconnect it. On a TU engine, it actually points straight up. So if you want to remove that PCV hose, you've got to squeeze it and pull up from the cylinder head in order to remove it from the valve cover. So just that minor difference can help be a really easy indicator for whether you're looking at a Gen 1 or a TU engine. People don't typically replace their valve covers, so it's really easy to see and not something that's likely to get mixed up if you're trying to tell the difference. Another good indicator is the charge pipe. So the charge pipe on the Gen 1 is two pieces, and it has a silicone coupler in the middle. You can see that pretty easily without even removing the engine cover in most cases. On a TU engine, it has sort of like this flex section up at the top by the throttle body. And that's also easy to see if you have the engine cover in place. You can see kind of like an accordion flex section right there. So that tells you that it's not a Gen 1. Another big difference is the intake manifold. So if they still have the stock manifold, you can tell pretty obviously what version B58 it is. On the Gen 1, it's all plastic and it kind of has this crosshatch design for the ribs on the plastic. And that is, you know, a sure tell sign that you're looking at a Gen 1 B58. If you look at a Gen 2, it kind of has these circles like a radial design that are spread out, and that'll tell you that it's a Gen 2. And then if you have a Gen 3, you'll see this really obviously because the whole intercooler in the intake manifold is exposed. So now it's not covered in plastic. You actually see the exposed metal, and that tells you for sure that you're working with a TU2 engine. Some people also like to highlight that it has port injection, but it's kind of hard to see. There are so many wires and hoses that run on top of the intake manifold that even though I even knew what I was looking for, I really had to like shine a light down there to even see anything. But if you do know what you're looking for and you're willing to dig in there, you can see the port injection rail, and that'll definitely tell you that you're working with a TU2 Gen 3 B58. Another difference that you can see is on the coil packs. On the Gen 1 and Gen 2, they're very similar, but on the Gen 3, they have a completely different coil pack design with a lot more going on top. So if you see that new design coil pack, then you know you're working with a TU2 engine. So lots of little things that you can look at all over the engine bay to kind of help tell the difference. I think the Gen 2 to Gen 3 is probably the most drastic difference that we've seen. But even looking between Gen 1 and Gen 2, you can see a couple differences with the bolt-ons and the different features on the engine. So now let's talk about which vehicles have which version of the B58. And for the lower tier, cheaper models, it's actually pretty easy to tell. Probably the most common and easy one that people can tell the difference on is with the 3 Series. So if you have an F30 340i and it looks like this, after the LCI was introduced in 2016, you know you have a Gen 1 B58. This was produced with the Gen 1 from 2016 to 2019. And then in 2020, they introduced the G20 M340i. So if your M340i looks like this, then you know that you have a 6-port TU engine. Now, this makes things very simple because those vehicles are completely different. There was a clear LCI changeover for the F30 when the B58 was introduced, and then a completely new model was introduced when the TU came out. but that's actually not the case for pretty much any of the other vehicles, so it does get a little bit more complicated. For example, with the M140i that was introduced in 2016, they actually never put a TU engine in this, so you know for sure if you have an M140i, it's going to have a Gen 1 B58. For the 2 series, they started putting it in 2017. The LCI actually came later, so you can have a pre-LCI M240 and still have the Gen 1 B58. Now, on top of that, they made this vehicle all the way until 2021. So even though they introduced the B58 TU in 2019, they still were making Gen 1 B58s in the M240. And this seems to cause some confusion because people have a 2020 or 21 and they assume that it's a TU engine when it's not. They only introduced the TU engine when it switched to the G42 M240i. Now, at least in this case, you also get a brand new model, so you know if you have this body style, it's a TU engine. If you have the old body style, then it's a Gen 1. For the 440i, kind of a similar story. They introduced it in 2017, even though it was still pre-LCI. They did the LCI in 2018, but all the way from 2017 to 2020, it was always a Gen 1 B58. In 2021, they introduced the M440i, and this G22 model is where the 6-port TU engine was introduced. Now, for these, it's pretty simple, because there's a brand new model introduced, and that's when the cutoff is. Even though the years are kind of staggered, you know with the new vehicle that you're getting the TU engine. Now, beyond this, it's not quite as clear, and you really have to pay attention to the model year that you're working with. So for example, with the G3540i, you're going to have a Gen 1 B58 for the vehicles that were made anywhere from 2017 to 2019. In 2020, they introduced the 2-port low-output B58 TU, and this was made from 2020 up until the current date. Even though the LCI came a little later, they were still putting the TU engines in some of the pre-LCI 540i's. For the 7 Series, this is the first one where we are actually seeing every single version of the B58. So it had the Gen 1 up until 2019, and then in 2020, it got the B58 TU up until 2022, and then in 2023, they introduced the 3rd generation TU2. So at some point, the 7 Series has seen every single version. Now, when we look at the X Series vehicles, it continues to be a little bit complicated. The X1 and X2 actually never got the B58, so we can ignore those. The X3 and the X4 got the Gen 1 B58 up until 2019. And then in 2020, it got the 6-port version of the B58. So even though these are bigger SUVs, they still got the higher output 6-port version, contrary to how things were managed with some of the other vehicles, where most of those bigger vehicles got the 2-port version. For the X5, the xDrive 40i was introduced in 2019 with the 2-port B58 TU. It's still built that way up until this day, so it has the lower output 2-port version. And then the X7 also got the 2-port low output B58 in 2019, but in 2023, they also switched to the TU2 along with the 740i. One thing I want to say is I'm not really sure why they put the low output version and most of the bigger vehicles. Typically in the past, it was the opposite. You know, they put the higher power version in the bigger vehicles because it had more weight to move around. But for whatever reason, that's how they broke things down. Now, last but not least, we have the Supra and the G29 Z4. Now, it is a little bit unique here, especially for the Supra. In 2020, they adopted the 2-port B58. But in 2021 onward, they are using the 6-port B58. So everybody that bought the first year felt like they got gypped because the second year it jumped up, you know, to 380 horsepower and they got this higher flowing cylinder head. Unfortunately, with the new DMEs being locked, it makes it a little more difficult to tune the newer Supras. But if you can get one before that June 20 cutoff, that's still a 6-port 2021. That's kind of like the sweet spot for making power and, you know, having a lot more performance benefits. For the Z4, they also produced it with the 2-port and the 6-port version. In the US, at least, they always produced it with the 6-port B58. But in Europe, they produced it with a 2-port B58 to help meet the stricter EU emission standards. So the 2-port cylinder head kind of integrates some of the manifold into the head, and that allows you to run coolant through it. That helps make things run more efficiently and can produce fewer emissions. So that's why you'll see a lot more of those with the 2-port cylinder head in Europe. and you kind of have to know where the vehicle came from or where you bought it in order to know what version of the B58 it has. Or, of course, you can just pop the hood and look at it. The difference between 2-port and 6-port is pretty noticeable when you look at the turbo. So the last thing that I want to talk about is this new TU2, because this has been quite a talking point in a lot of different groups I'm in, and especially with the M340i guys. Some people think that the TU2 is in their car if they have an LCI, and then when they realize it's not, they feel like it's never coming to the 3 Series. But hopefully, talking through this, you guys kind of see how BMW staggers some of their implementation for different engines and LCI models versus vehicle types. It's not really flat across the board. You know, in 2020, they were making the Gen 1 and the 2-port B58 TU and the 6-port TU all at the same time, depending on what vehicle you were looking at. So it's really complicated to just assume that now that we have an LCI, we're never going to see a TU2, because they're just going to keep it the same until the M340 G20 runs out. I don't think that's the case, and we still have the M440 and M240 LCI on the horizon. So I'm assuming that in either 2024 or maybe even 2025, we'll see the new TU2 come down into, you know, the 3 Series and 2 Series vehicles. We'll just kind of have to wait and see, but it's not abnormal by any means compared to what BMW has done in the past. So just be patient. You know, if you're waiting for that, we definitely should see it in the next 1 to 2 years, just based on how BMW has done things in the past. Hopefully we can get some nice tunes going for those cars as well. I know they have a new DME, but there is a big opportunity with, you know, all the benefits of the improved cooling and, you know, the better fueling and everything that's in there. It just seems like something that'll be really popular from a tuning aspect. So, yeah, that's all the information I have. Again, hopefully this answers all of your questions. Sorry this video was a little bit long. I'll try to, you know, put chapters in the description so you guys can figure out where you want to go and jump to whatever section is most important to you at the time. But I just kind of wanted to put all this together for everybody that can't quite grasp, you know, what the different generations of B58 are and how they stack up in the BMW lineup. So if you see people talking about it and kind of going back and forth trying to figure out which B58 is which, send them this video. That'll help me out a lot as well. You know, share this with all of your other BMW and B58 friends. And yeah, hopefully you guys, you found this informative. So that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. If you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do